One football. All you need is one football. A football app that brings together all the latest news and in-match updates to football fans all over the world. One football covers over 100 international leagues and competitions live and in incomparable detail.
Wow!
Pick a team, any team. You'll receive live updates from the team you follow around the clock. Make sure you download One Football today to ensure you get a great result. We done, Director? Alright, cheers.
Out the Fir Park tunnel.
Hey guys, Goggsy here, and today we're back with another Around the Ground. Today it is Partick Thistle at home. Come on the well.
What's the hardest thing you've ever done? I mean, I'm walking through Hamilton right now wearing a Motherwell scarf. I think that constitutes to my hardest thing I've ever done. But anyway, welcome to episode 178 of Around the Grounds. Partick Thistle at home, let's do this. So off to the GG's now, bought headphones, only £8, so it's alright. Because we've got to listen to something on the way home, because it's just me today basically. Everyone's ditched me. Cry every time, but if we get 3 points then I don't care. It's just gone 2:30, Kilmarnock beat Celtic 1-0. So we are desperately needing the 3 points to stay in the top six this week. Here's hoping. I'm actually quite confident, because we've got a good track record here against Partick Thistle. I think we'll win 2-0. Hopefully Curtis Main to score again. Maybe Nadir to get one as well. But come on, let's get someone here. Oh dear.
In my opinion,
I want to cry, but I want to laugh at the same time because of Manfred. But I 1-0 down against Partick Thistle, not the best thing. Come on, let's get one back. Oofed. Hey, got a free kick out of it. Go on. Oh! Oh! Go on, L. Come on. Oh. Oh no. Oh! Yeah! Oh, what? What? Before I head to the Jack Daniels, of course, I had to get my ticket for next week. Looking forward to it. But first, we've got St. Johnson to deal with on Tuesday. Another check through here. It's gotta love being me. Right, so the time is currently like 25 to 8, I think. I've had a few drinks. Time for that solitary trip back to Fife. Sunny Fife. But I, Motherwell drew, oh well. At least we're still undefeated at home against Partick Thistle since 1996, I think it was. I certainly wasn't alive, but aye, that's quite funny. But aye, we'll do a wee match analysis after this wee trip montage and my trip to McDonald's. That goal Curtis Main scored that was offside, apparently. I still don't think it was. I got it on film as well. I mean, I'm pretty sure Nadir ran in to the back. I think it was him that was actually flagged for offside. And he just headed the ball across and Main was actually in line with the ball, I think. I'm not entirely sure, I'll have to watch it back. But yeah, so we drew 1-0 with Thistle. I mean, it's better than getting beat, I suppose. I mean, we could, a different Motherwell team would have lost that game. Right there. But yeah, let's get to that gaff. Analysis time. Having watched the offside goal, I can confirm, yeah, it was only just offside. It was Nadir Chiefchi's left foot that was offside. And it was so tight, it was that close. But referee, or the linesman, that's probably the best bit of assistant refereeing I've ever seen. However, throughout the second half especially, the lineup was absolutely terrible until he got that decision spot on. But apart from everything else, I mean, there was especially one point where Curtis Main had his shirt being tugged for about 5 seconds and he fell down, because sometimes after the contact you just have to give way, and then nothing was given. And Partick Thistle players were diving all over the place at 1-0 and they were still time wasting at 1-1. However, if it were my team, I'd be wanting them to do the same. But it's not the first time I've complained about Partick Thistle time wasting, but if your team's winning,
you want them to run down the clock as much as possible, because sometimes you don't have the faith in your team to score another. Sometimes what I feel with Motherwell, because Motherwell is the sort of team that if we are 2-0 up, we need a third, because you never know what's going to happen. Also, very good to see Nadir get his first goal for the club. I never thought I'd see the day where I'd be cheering on Nadir Chiefchi, because I despised him when he played for Dundee United, but I love him playing for Motherwell. He almost reminds me of when James McFadden was in his prime. He's honestly so good on the ball, so skillful. The next four games now are really important. We've got St Johnstone at home on Tuesday, then Dundee away in the Cup on Saturday. I would honestly take a replay, because a night out in Dundee after our team gets beat, don't fancy it. But if we do get it to a replay, I'll be happy with that. But obviously we do want to win. But the only reason I'd happily take a replay is it gets me another video. Then Kilmarnock at home on the 17th, then Dundee away on the 24th, then Aberdeen at home on the 28th, but that's a wee bit further away. So aye, the next four games especially, they are monumental. We've got 1 point out of three so far out of these five games. Alright, I suppose it's not so bad if we win on Tuesday, but aye. Anyway guys, that'll be the end of the video. I really hope you enjoyed. I hope the critics don't get too harsh on Manpete. I mean, when I was at the Well Boys section in the first half, they were calling Manpete a fat so-and-so. So I think it's only right that he ran down to celebrate, because I'd be doing the same. I've had opposition fans, when they've been beating us, shouting, "Gogsy, what's the score?" or something like that. I've just had to take it all on the chin. But I've not really had a chance to go like that back. But honestly, I wouldn't think anything of it, because it's just banter at the end of the day, and Manpete is a banter merchant, especially on Twitter. Certainly winds a lot of folk up. But yeah, anyway guys, I'll see you on the next video. Also, I'm going to be part of a sports show on my college radio, which is called BSN, Boom Sports News. It'll predominantly be about football, because that's most of what we know. But I'll leave a link in the description for the YouTube channel that we're going to make, and it'll have just like best bets and stuff like that. We're going to start getting like proper equipment as well. So we'll actually have like a video podcast, which is much better to watch than just having the audio running in the background of just some FIFA footage. But aye, that's a long-term goal, and I'll leave a link in the description for that. Anyway guys, I'll see you later. Take care. She said, L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. You got more than money and sense, my friend. You got heart, and you go in your own way. L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. What you don't have now will come back again. You got heart, and you go in your own way.